Hi everyone. In our previous slides, we have discussed about the topics wherein we were preparing the ratios based on the balance sheets. But this sort of category is we are preparing the balance sheet based on the ratios available. Let us see a practical problem here. That is, with the help of the information given below, prepare trading and profit and loss account and balance sheet. Here we are required to prepare trading and profit and loss account and balance sheet with the help of these ratios, that is the gross profit ratio, net profit ratio, sales to inventory ratio, fixed assets to current assets, current ratio, fixed assets to share capital. But he has given the values for fixed assets and closing stock. So here, if we check with the gross profit, the formula for gross profit ratio will be gross profit divided by sales into 100. To decode this ratio, we neither have gross profit, we neither have the value for sales. So we cannot compute anything from this gross profit ratio. For this net profit ratio, the formula will be net profit divided by sales into 100. Neither here we can calculate the net profit or the value for sales. Then third sort of category, that is sales to inventory ratio. Here, inventory means stock, but we have the value of stock over here, that is 40,000. So we can calculate this ratio. Let us try to solve this problem now. So let's start with the sales to inventory ratio because we have the value of stock over here. So the formula for sales to inventory ratio will be sales divided by inventory. So in the place of sales to inventory ratio, I will write 10, which is equals to, instead of sales, we have not calculated sales yet, so it will be blank, divided by inventory. Inventory we have in the form of closing stock, that is 40,000. So with the help of cross multiplication, we can get the value of sales. That is, if we cross multiply it, the equation will be like sales is equals to stock into sales to inventory ratio. That is, stock 40,000 into sales to inventory ratio is 10. So which will come to 4 lakh. So now here we have the value of sales, that is 4 lakh. With the help of sales, in this problem, we can calculate gross profit ratio as well as net profit ratios. So in the next slides, let us calculate our gross profit ratio and net profit ratios. So the gross profit ratio says that is 24% on the sales. So the gross profit ratio is equals to gross profit divided by sales into 100. Now if you interpret this, the equation will be in this form, 25 divided by 100, that is 25% will be 25 divided by 100, which is equals to gross profit divided by the value of sales, that is 4 lakhs. We don't know the value of gross profit, hence we are leaving gross profit as it is. With the help of cross multiplication, we can get the value of the gross profit. With this equation, gross profit is equals to sales into gross profit ratio, that is 4 lakh into 25 by 100, that is 1 lakh. This 1 lakh is the value of gross profit. So in the same fashion, we can calculate the value for net profit. That is, net profit is 20% on sales. The formula is net profit ratio is equals to net profit divided by sales into 100. So the formula can be interpreted as 20 divided by 100, because 20% simplifies 20 divided by 100, which is equals to net profit divided by sales. The value for sales we know, that is 4 lakh. Now with the help of cross multiplication, we can get the value for net profit. That is, net profit is equals to sales into net profit ratio. That is 4 lakh into 20 by 100. The value of net profit is 80,000. So now if you look at the question, we have gross profit, we have net profit, and even we have solved the sales to inventory ratio. That is, we have calculated the sales. Now leftover ratios are fixed assets to current assets ratio, current ratio, fixed assets to share capital. These are the three ratios which are left out. With the help of the value of fixed assets, we can compute these three ratios. Let us calculate it. First, let us calculate fixed assets to current assets. So the formula for fixed assets to current assets ratio will be fixed assets divided by current assets. So the ratio for fixed assets to current assets ratio is 5:8, that is 5:8, which means 5 is related to the fixed assets, 8 is related to the current assets. So which is equals to fixed assets value we have, that is 4 lakh, which is provided in the question. So 4 lakh divided by current assets. Current assets we are not sure what is the value. So we can calculate the value of current assets with the help of cross multiplication. That is, current assets is equals to fixed assets into fixed assets to current assets ratio. That is 4 lakh into 8 by 5. which is equals to 640,000. This is the value of our current assets. So now when we have got our current assets, we can calculate the current ratio, that is current liabilities. Calculation of current liabilities based on current assets. Current ratio we have, the value of current assets we have. Now we need to calculate current liabilities, which can be equated as 1 divided by 1, because the ratio is 1. 1 divided by 1, which is equals to 640,000 in the place of current assets divided by current liabilities. With the help of cross multiplication, we can get the value for current liabilities. That is, current liabilities is equals to current assets into current ratio. That is 640,000 into 1 divided by 1. So again, which means the current liabilities are also 640,000. Because the ratio itself specifies that current ratio is 1, which means 1 is to 1. If our current assets are 1 rupees, then our current liabilities will also be 1 rupees. So hence, the value of current assets in this problem is also 640,000. The value of current liabilities will be 640,000. Now let us calculate the third sort of ratio, that is fixed assets to share capital ratio. Here we have fixed assets to share capital is equals to fixed assets divided by capital. You have to interpret this in the formula. The ratio is 5:4, which means 5 are fixed assets and 4 is share capital. So we have to divide it accordingly. 5 divided by 4, which is equals to fixed assets 4 lakh divided by capital. So with the help of cross multiplication, we can get the value of share capital. That is, capital is equals to fixed assets to share capital, which is equals to 4 lakh into 4 by 5, which means the amount will come to 3,20,000 rupees. So now here we have solved all sort of ratios here. We have got the value of gross profit in gross profit ratio. We have got the value of net profit in net profit ratio. We have got sales value in sales to inventory ratio. We have got the current asset value in fixed assets to current asset ratio. We have got the current liabilities value in the current ratio. We have got the share capital value in fixed assets to share capital ratio. Apart from this, we have few more calculation. That is, calculation of expenses as well as cost of goods sold. These are used in our trading and profit and loss account. So let us calculate the expenses. So the value of gross profit is 1 lakh and the value of net profit is 80,000, which means there is an expenses which has incurred, because the 20,000 has been decreased in the value of gross profit to obtain the net profit. So that information is nowhere provided in this question. So we have to think logically that gross profit is 1 lakh and net profit is 80,000. What about the remaining amount? It is called as an expenses. The expenses of 20,000 has been incurred and that 20,000 will be transferred to profit and loss account debit side. There is a value of sales, there is a value of closing stock, there is a value for gross profit, but there is no value related to the purchase or cost of goods sold, which we have to specify in the trading account. Hence, we have to calculate cost of goods sold or purchase value. That is, closing stock plus sales, that is the value will be 4,40,000. From that, if we subtract gross profit, we obtain the value of cost of goods sold, that is 3,40,000. This cost of goods sold, that is 3,40,000, will be transferred to trading account debit side. Next, calculation of liquid assets. If you see in this problem, we have calculated current assets worth rupees 6,40,000, but there is a closing stock given over here in the form of value, that is 40,000. Now, if you think about liquid assets, the formula for liquid assets is current asset minus stock minus prepaid expenses. Now, when we have current assets value here, when we have the value of stock, we can easily calculate the liquid assets, which is equals to current asset 6,40,000 less closing stock 40,000. The value remaining is called as liquid assets. Now, with the help of all this information, we can prepare trading profit and loss account and balance sheet, which I am going to explain in the next slide. That is, trading and profit and loss account. The cost of goods sold we have calculated in our previous slide, and the information sales we have calculated. The value of closing stock is given in this problem. So gross profit we have calculated. So together our trading account is completed. Now same gross profit has been brought down into P&L account. Expenses we have calculated in our previous slide itself. That is 20,000. The remaining net profit also we have calculated in the ratio itself. So this completes our trading and profit and loss account. Now let us calculate the balance sheet. Let us draft a balance sheet. In this balance sheet, we have calculated share capital with the help of fixed assets to share capital ratio. that is the value of 320,000 rupees. Then we have incurred a profit in this year, so hence we are replicating that profit in this balance sheet. And apart from that, we have calculated current liabilities with the help of current ratio. So the value is 640,000. Coming to asset side, fixed assets he has given in the question itself, that is 4 lakh rupees. And with the help of fixed assets to current assets ratio, we have calculated the value for current assets, that is 640,000. This 640,000 is the combination of closing stock 40,000 plus liquid assets 6 lakh. Together it will come to 640,000. So in this fashion, the balance sheet will get tallied to 1040,000. So likewise, when preparing balance sheet with the help of ratios, there are certain logical things we have to think. In that fashion, we can solve these sort of problems. So I request you guys to solve all sort of illustration and exercise problems from your textbook. And if you have any doubt regarding this, you can reach out to me at any time. Don't hesitate to reach out to me for any doubts. Please go ahead and contact me. Thank you.